So to get us underway in this final group. Always exciting. They go into this free dance line.White. Their music for the free dance, Notre Dame de Paris. Just an amazing entry into that. Just amazing speed and control on those twizzles. Just sensational. And that shot says it all. They gave that everything they had. Gracie Gold there. The American team leading the applause. That was an amazing skate from Marilyn Charlie. Don't know about you, but I've got goosebumps. Charlie White, always on the limit. I can't take my eyes off him when he's out there. That was unbelievable. Well, the program's done them proud this season. You can see he's absolutely down and out. It is so physically demanding in this arena. He couldn't have given any more. I'm talking about him, of course. Merrill did a great job too. Between them, absolutely fantastic. Marina and Oleg greet them at the door, and they must be ecstatic with the performance from these two. The speed on the rotational lift was just defied belief. The twizzles fast across the ice. The rotation was quick. And I've been talking about depth of knee bend and really letting the skates work for you, getting as much as you can out of the skate. And these two tick all the boxes there. There they are, synchronized twizzles, perfect unison through that. Just amazing. Well, it's always difficult to pick between Merrill and Charlie and Tessa and Scott. They're going head to head. It'll be the Canadians going next. Remember, there's half a point between them. ...112.38 is the best score that these two have ever got on the free dance. 188.55, their best total score. But I tell you, that was special.
The score, please.
Davis, White組の得点.
Well, they're going to lead, but by how much? So 112.68, so that's a new personal best for them. That's fantastic. Will it be enough for them to win here? Remember, they're half a point behind the Canadians. The Canadians next to go. That was a sensational performance. And Oleg Epstein sat alongside, leading the applause, rightly so. Well done to the team. So catch your breath. The leaders, the world champions, the Olympic champions, where they were runners-up in Sochi in the Grand Prix finals, finished behind the Americans. This is Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer. Music, Carmen.
Thank you.
Oh no, what's happened? Dear me, I don't know what's happened here, but it doesn't look as though they're going to continue. Something happened there. I didn't see what it was, but
Mike,
she's struggling to breathe. Yeah. Well, I'm not really sure what the situation is. I think she was really struggling to breathe. Didn't hear about a problem at the beginning, but I look at that part again. Everything seemed to be going really, really well, and then well,
yeah, can we start from that?
So it looks like they're going to start from where they stopped.
For like 2 minutes and then I'll pick it up.
I don't know if it's an injury or whatever it is, we wish them well. So the music steward sounds like it's going to play from around 2 minutes, and they'll pick it up from where they stopped. The lift they were going for before the incident occurred. Well, that was quite remarkable. Well, they're both breathing hard. And smiling now, everybody on their feet. It is physically demanding. I've said it before, but it's a tough place to skate this. It's pretty warm in the arena. And if you are under the weather, if there's anything wrong with you, it's going to be testing. She looks completely down and out. Amazing expression. Fantastic lifts. The program was flawless, but it did have that stop, didn't it? Now that shouldn't reflect in anything. Just amazing innovation. How you pick between Marilyn Charlie and Tessa and Scott. Both very, very different programs. And that was the point where they had the stop. I'm actually surprised that they allowed them to do that lift again. But there it was. So remember, these two finished second in the Grand Prix finals behind the Americans. They need 112.25 to win. And they've got a personal best of 112.33. Tessa getting her skates off. Maybe it's an ankle injury. We'll find out more and let you know. But here we go. 112.25 the target. 109.20. It's not going to be enough. It's the best they've got this season. But that won't do it, and he knows it. So it's second place for the Canadians, Tessa and Scott. Finished behind Merrill and Charlie. 4.32,
which brings them currently in second place.
So it's going to be the Americans that win and the Canadians in second. But there's a battle for the silver and the bronze medals. These two have an outside shot. They're going to have to skate their socks off here. Lying in fifth place going into this. This is Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier from Canada.
Thank you.
Oh, they really attack those twizzles. Wow, really entertaining performance that. Kevin Reynolds leading the applause there for the Canadian team. So they're about 5 points off a medal, so it's unlikely that they're going to be moving into a medal position. And remember, they've got Shibatani's ahead of them in fourth place, and Madison Chock and Evan Bates in that bronze medal position at the moment. So it's a tough ask. And he's been on the podium before, finished third, what, a couple of years ago? I may remember with Vanessa Crone. But that really was a super skate. No problems that I saw. Really attack those twizzles. Good balance point in the lift. That shows great control. Here's those twizzles. Synchronization was good between them. Back inside one there is a little all over the place, but stayed safe. Competed in the Trophy Bombay in Paris this year, where they finished down in sixth place. And Skate Canada, they finished fourth. That was a good result for them.
Hi, Mom and Dad.
Hi,
Mom and Dad. Hi, Jordan.
Certainly look pleased. Well, their personal best for the free dance is 83.87, so a 97.63. That is a great score for them. Wow. So they go into third place. So remember, there's two to go. But that has put the pressure on. Beaming smiles there from Piper and Paul. Great job done. The judges loved it, and so did we.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you. Let's stay arigato.
So down to the last two. These two having a sensational season. Runners up in nationals a couple of weeks ago. Beat the Shibutanis. This is Madison Chock and Evan Bates. Music from Dr. Zhivago. Well, some fantastic innovation in there. A really super program. Madison Chock, Evan Bates. Beautiful interpretation to the music from Dr. Zhivago. These two teamed up a couple of years ago. both been pretty successful with different partners, but this partnership certainly seems to be one that's gelling very, very quickly. Some really difficult transitions, and look at the change of hold through there. Amazing speed. Perhaps a little slow for me, the first section. I know the music was slow, but they could have generated a little bit more speed across the ice, perhaps. That would be my only criticism, but there was so much to admire. The synchronized twizzles there, great speed, perfect poise, and look at that for control and balance. Amazing emotion. Remember, these two in third place at the moment. They've got the Shibutanis hot on their heels. What's the gap between them? A couple of points. Yeah, in fact, they've got a 2.2-point lead over the Shibutanis going into the free. So that performance may well be enough to lock them in for a medal here. So they should finish this in third place. 94.98 the score there. That's a personal best for them by some way. 90.28 was their previous personal best. So things going very much in the right direction for Madison and Evan. They go into third place. They'll have to wait until the next team to find out whether they go home with a bronze medal from here. So their total score, a personal best by a long way. Here we go then, the final couple. The bronze medalists in the US National Championships a couple of weeks ago. Remember, they were bronze medalists in the World Championships 2 years ago. But things not going according to plan at the moment. This is Maya and Alex Shibutani. The music, Memories of a Geisha. Thank you. I'll tell you what, that is the best I've seen them skate for a while. That was a cracking performance. It's amazing, isn't it, when you look at the relationship between them. It's hard to imagine their brother and sister when they're out there skating. So supportive of each other. Absolutely fantastic. They've come here to Japan. Perfect theme. The American team there cheering. And rightly so. Max Aaron, Gracie Gold sat there. Well, that really was a very, very good skate. I don't honestly think they could have performed that program any better. Wow, it's all smiles. Now remember, they were... they 3 points, 3.2 behind Madison and Evan. In fact, Piper and Paul, the Canadian team, they finished third on the free dance. Not enough for them to get themselves into a podium position, but they closed the gap, so very well done to them. So it's Madison Chock and Evan Bates in third place at the moment, but it's going to be mighty close. I tell you, these guys could not have done any more. They skated their hearts out here right at the end of the competition. It's going to go right down to the wire. One thing's for sure though, it's going to be America first, Canada second, and America third. But which team is going to finish on the podium? So 96.71. That's close to a personal best for them. It's a season's best. Won't be enough. So fourth place it is. So a good effort. 159.97 their total score. They've closed the gap by some way. The damage was done though in the short dance. So what a competition that turned out to be. The Shibutani's did beat Madison and Evan on the free dance, but there was not enough there. Piper and Paul in fifth place there, third on the free dance they were. So good news for them, but it's Merrill Davis and Charlie White the win. Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer, the world champions, the Olympic champions, having to settle for second place after that stop midway through the program. That's the situation further down. What a competition that turned out to be. Went right down to the wire. It was a nail-biting finish at the end of the day. And the Shibutanis actually were, less than half a point away from a bronze medal. But it's Davis and White that win. So that's the end of the competition. It's been an amazing event, this Four Continents Championships. And a look here at some of the highlights. The bronze medalists, runners-up in the U.S. Nationals a couple of weeks ago in Omaha, Nebraska. This is Madison Chock and Evan Bates. Could only manage a fifth place finish on the free dance. It was a real nail biter for them. The Shibutanis finished ahead of them, and so did Piper Giles and Paul Poirier. But they had enough in hand from that super short dance to keep them on the podium. A lovely interpretation to the music from Dr. Zhivago. That, for me, one of the highlights. Fantastic. Right at the end of the program. And then an amazing performance from Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer. Flawless. But they did have to stop midway through. We still don't know what the reason for that was. Picked it up again. Kept the intensity right to the end of the program. But at the end of the day, it wasn't enough to maintain that lead that they had going into this from the short dance. That's where the problem occurred. And Scott really taking charge. He looking after it. So after a 2 minute break, which is permitted, they picked it up from where they left off, which was this point. On to the end, got there unscathed. But the evening, without any shred of a doubt, belonged to these two. Unbelievable scenes. And that picture really does tell the story. These two gave it 110%, if that's possible. Merrill Davis and Charlie White. They're having an amazing season, there's no doubt about it. They won Skate America. They won the NHK trophy here. And won the Grand Prix finals in Sochi, which of course is the venue for the Olympic Winter Games in just under a year's time. And the duel between Merrill and Charlie and Tessa and Scott continues. Well, I hope you enjoyed our coverage of the four continents. It's been fantastic. And for now, goodbye.
Champions League intensifies the pressure. The biggest clubs with the best players ever fronting up to get their hands on the ultimate prize. Handball Champions League group stage day 8 tonight on Eurosport 2.
Kevin Reynolds, very popular all around the world. If you haven't seen him before, you'll see why in the next 4 minutes or so. Not really achieved at the highest level on major international competition, although looking back, he was third here.